The narrator Prometheus speaks of a prophecy that will depose Zeus, who rules over a modern world. Eurydice already meets a mysterious woman at the store, who tells her it is time to leave her partner, the musician Orpheus, whom she has fallen out of love with. Zeus's son, Dionysus, desires more responsibility, but is rebuffed by both Zeus and Zeus's sister wife, Hera. Dionysus spitefully steals Zeus's watch. Zeus, already upset over an Olympia Day monument desecrated by Trojans, frets over a vertical wrinkle in his forehead and summons Prometheus to assure him that a prophecy foretelling his reign's end will not come to pass. Rhede visits her mother at Tacita, who shares Zeus's prophecy with her. Rhede is then hit by a bus and killed. A heartbroken Orpheus tries to commit suicide, but Dionysus interrupts to tell him of a way he can be reunited with her. Eurydice's journey through the underworld is interrupted after it is revealed Orpheus took the coin intended to pay her passage. Meanwhile, Caeneus, an underworld handler and another of the three mortals identified by Prometheus as critical to the prophecy, is unwillingly promoted to a diver who helps souls through the Lethe. To Hera's disgust, Zeus has been impregnating mortal women in an attempt to sire a child he can have a good relationship with. After realizing the mortals are content, he decides to terrorize them against Prometheus's advice. Eurydice is told she needs to work for the underworld for 200 years. Dionysus takes Orpheus to the cave where mortals can win passage through the underworld if they impress the judges. One of them, Lachesis, disqualifies Orpheus because he took Rhede's coin, but is convinced to allow them through the underworld in exchange for Zeus's watch. Ari assists her father, President Minos of Crete, in investigating the desecration of the monument, which was, without their knowledge, done with their employee Theseus's help. Hecuba and Andromache, former members of Troy's royal family, are interrogated by Minos over the Trojan Seven. Minos threatens to send the six members in custody to the Minotaur if the leader doesn't surrender. Zeus complains about the situation to Poseidon, who appears directly to Minos and implores him to get revenge. Theseus takes Ari to a gladiator fight where she admits she has received the same prophecy Zeus and Rhede were given. Theseus brings Ari to his lover Astyanax, the seventh Trojan, who intends to turn himself in, and asks for her to save his life. Minos pardons the seven at Ari's request, but a displeased Poseidon threatens Minos. A raid is carried out on the Trojans, and the seven are killed and displayed on the monument. The Furies visit a heartbroken Ari to discuss her brother. Before his imprisonment, Prometheus asks his lover Charon to look out for someone with a mark. Then he kills him. Orpheus enters the underworld with fellow cave contestant Anatole. Persephone tries to tell Zeus about a soul who has disappeared from the underworld, but Hades stops her and insists he will fix it. Caeneus secretly visits his former Cerberus Fotis and comes across Nax. Rhede is recruited to be a diver and befriends Caeneus. Dionysus admits his gambit with Orpheus to Poseidon, but Poseidon tells him that Zeus will not like it if Orpheus succeeds and implores him to get the watch back. Dionysus procures a replica, satisfying Zeus. Charon encounters Orpheus and Anatole and offers to drive them across the Styx. Midway through, he admits he can only take one. As Orpheus attacks Anatole, Charon recognizes the mark on his hand and kills Anatole. Zeus brings Dionysus into his plan to strike fear in humanity. Rhede and Caeneus find a room full of corpses. The Furies show Ari a video revealing Minos's past. Indebted to Poseidon, he had received a prophecy claiming his first child to draw breath would be his end. So he would have an heir, Poseidon ensured Minos sired twins, and Minos ordered Daedalus to deal with baby Glaucus. A disbelieving Ari confronts Minos, but he dodges her questioning. Later, Daedalus confirms her suspicions and reveals Glaucus is the Minotaur. Through the Tacita, Zeus becomes convinced Hera is plotting against him, but she convinces him that she has no secrets. In the underworld room, Reedy faints as Hades takes Nax's soul. When Orpheus awakens, Charon asks if he is ready. As a parched Orpheus tries to find Reedy, Canaeus tells Reedy that when he was a teenager, his male best friend Laios was killed for returning to the Amazons. His mother, knowing he was transgender, sent him away to Crete. Canaeus and Reedy sleep together and learn they have the same prophecy, piecing together that souls who go through the frame enter the nothing. The two decide to stop people from going through the frame. Persephone and Hades confront Zeus about the overload of souls in the nothing, claiming the frame needs to be reset, and renewal needs to resume for the world to rebalance. Prometheus gives Zeus the idea for Minos to kill Glaucus, to prove that prophecies can be defied. Poseidon and Hera give Minos a knife. Clotho offers Orpheus water, but he claims he would rather die trying to bring Reedy back. Having passed the test, he is transported to Asphodel and reunited with Reedy. A dismayed Dionysus goes to report this to Poseidon, but learns of his affair with Hera. Orpheus apologizes to Reedy, but she is reluctant to return to the living world with him. As Dionysus, Poseidon, and Hera tiptoe about the affair, Zeus hosts a barbecue to watch Minos defy his prophecy. Daedalus explains that Glaucus grew feral in isolation before eventually becoming the Minotaur. Canaeus tells Reedy she can encourage humans on the surface to live for themselves and not for the gods. Hades refuses to let Orpheus and Reedy leave, but Persephone, intending to send Zeus a message, allows them to return to life behind Hades' back. Ari demands to be taken to Glaucus. Glaucus gores Daedalus, but Ari is able to comfort him. Minos arrives and fatally stabs Glaucus. Zeus assumes victory, but Ari, who drew breath before her brother despite being the younger twin, kills her father, fulfilling Minos' prophecy. Hades asks Medusa to assist Persephone in running the underworld as he focuses on fixing the nothing. Zeus kills the Fates, thinking it will stop all prophecies. As they burn, Lachesis returns his watch and tells him Dionysus took it. On the path to return to Earth, Reedy admits that she no longer loves Orpheus. Canaeus is reunited with his mother and inadvertently follows her into the frame. Zeus confronts the family and orders that they fall into line. Dionysus admits that he had traded Zeus's watch to bring Orpheus into the underworld, but Persephone lies that Orpheus failed. Poseidon declares his love for Hera, but she rebuffs him. Ari shows Glaucus's corpse to Pasiphae and declares that she will not rule Crete for the gods. Reedy re-encounters Cassandra, who tells her that she is now a prophet and must help Ari set the living free, as Canaeus will do for the dead. Canaeus wakes up in the nothing and manages to renew his mother's soul, to Hades' surprise. Prometheus arrives on Olympus. Zeus bleeds, and the Meander fountain falls. Hera tells one of her children to gather the troops, and Ari strikes a deal with Hecuba.